Glory. What about that flashing? Why is that flashing? Why is that light flashing? I don't know why. I don't know why that light is flashing, but no, stop it. Okay. Okay. So this is walking the light. Learned that by Jesse Dixon, Guy Perrod. Yes, walking the light. We are going to continue with what we started 2 weeks ago. Again, talking about how we need to, in fact, we started with following the light 2 weeks ago, and last Sunday we moved on to, thank you very much, Jesse Dixon and Guy Perrod. Yes, we started with walking, following the light, that was the title, 2 weeks ago. And then last Sunday, we moved on to look at explore the topic, look at the light. Look at the light. Tonight, the topic is from darkness to light. Okay, so I hope you're ready. I don't know what this signal, I never seen this. I don't know what this is. I don't know what this is. I don't know what, in picture. What on earth is that? Okay. Gone, and that camera still flashing, so I don't know what's happening now. And I wish somebody could just give me feedback to tell me how this is showing on their appliances. Okay, but I'll just move on here by faith, thanking God for another opportunity to come through to you guys, and by extension the people who will watch this hereafter, people who, you know, who will receive this recording, this live recording. Yes, maybe we will have it shared to them by friends. So I'm going to start unofficially. I say this is Reverend Cyril Okere, and tonight, you are watching the Sentinel. The Sentinel is the immediate arm of Citygate Ministries International. Right. Let me say this right. Okay. As I said before, just move right ahead. we're looking at the topic, follow the light, which is again the third installment of the topic we started 2 weeks ago, with follow the theme we started 2 weeks ago with the topic follow the light. Okay, let me just go straight into the scriptures. I want to look at interesting. Okay. Right. Hold on. I need to get my not ready here. Open it up. Good. We have it. Okay. So I don't have anybody here at the moment. Should I wait? Should I continue? Should I wait? Should I continue? I just want someone to give me some kind of feedback that all is well. All is well. Should, don't know. Maybe I should. This has come again. Maybe I should wait to alert people again that we're on to say Citygate or the Sentinel is on. Okay, the Sentinel, yeah, some people need reminding. The Sentinel, yes, the Sentinel, yeah. I don't like talking to myself, yeah. I know people do join later on. Also people watch it and give their feedback and all that. But I don't like talking to myself. I don't like it. No, it doesn't flow with me. I don't flow with that technique. I'm still learning. Okay, the city gate is now on. Is giant. Joining. Okay, yes. Okay. That's what I want to let people know, that we are on, that they should do what? They should join us. Okay, that's it. That's what I want to say to them. Good. Right. Okay. Yes, 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 yes. That's it. That's it. Okay, that's it. All right. Let me just move on. Let me move on. Thank you, Jesus. Well, there's nobody here. I preach to myself, speak to myself. I enjoy it. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Lord, I thank you. Thank you for your word. The trust of your word gives light. Oh, yes. And this understanding to the simple. I ask, oh God, that you give me the inspiration to speak as the oracle of God. Oh Lord, that you sharpen my tongue, oh God, for this purpose, as it might speak like the pen of resurrector uttering that which concerns you, oh my King. I pray, oh God, that the hearers will be blessed as the word percolates into their heart and find lodgment, and it's engrafted. It will bring the result for which the word is spoken. Thank you, Lord. Your word will not come back to you void. Thank you, Lord, because every spirit of distraction and cynicism and misunderstanding and mistreatment is hereby proscribed and bound in Jesus' name. I ask, oh God, Lord, that this word, your word, will run swiftly. Yes, Lord, to the extent that what we're sharing tonight is your truth, is consistent with your heart, then let it run swiftly, let it run unhindered. Let it, oh God, penetrate even the walls erected by the enemies and the blindfolds, just used by the enemy to blind people's eyes. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen. Right. Thank you, Cyril Okere. Thank you very much. Everything all right? The office all right? Okay. Let's go to the scriptures right away. I'm reading from Romans chapter 13. Romans 13. So let verse what? Romans 13, 12. 12. I start from verse 12. Okay. I read from King James Version, New King James Version. since the night is far spent, the day is at hand. In fact, let me start from 11. I like to say, and do this, knowing the time that now it is high time to awake out of sleep. For now, our salvation is nearer than when we first believed. The night is far spent, the day is at hand. Therefore, let us cast off the works of darkness and let us put on the armor of light. Let us walk properly as in the day, not in revelry and drunkenness, not in lewdness and lust, not in strife and envy, but put on the Lord Jesus Christ and make no provision for the flesh to fulfill its lust. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. 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 I want to get another scripture. Another scripture. Let me just put it here to read from here. Again, the NKJ. There. Version. Okay. So this scripture again. But you are, from verse 9, but you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, his own, that's God's own special people, that you may know the praise, that you may proclaim. What's that? This message again. What is it? A web page is slowing down your browser. What should you all like to do? Stop it. Which web page is that? Do I have any web page? Oh no. You know what? Sorry. Oh God, this is sick. Wait. Okay, fine. Wait. Fine. Wait. I start again. Sorry for that option. Oh God, this is flashing badly. What is that with page? Okay, I ignore it. Let me ignore it. Okay, I continue. I start again. But you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, his own special people, that you may proclaim the praise of his marvelous light, who once were not a people, but are now the people of God, who had not obtained mercy, but now have obtained mercy. Amen. We are called to show forth the praise of him who called us out of darkness into his marvelous light. I go back. All right. Yeah, thank you. You guys, it's fine. All right. Praise God. Hallelujah. All right. So the topic is from darkness to light. From darkness to light. Hallelujah. From darkness to light. Okay. Now, darkness is the habitat of a natural man. A natural man, that's the, what's the natural man? I mean, the ordinary human being who is not born again, who is not regenerated, who is not in Christ. We are born in sin. So, and we sinned, you know. Yeah, we sin as humans. The Bible says that we are enemies of God in our mind, in our hearts, in our attitudes, in our motives, in our, you know, motivations, in our affections. So the natural unregenerated man has his own habitat. In darkness, or has darkness as his own habitat. We are comfortable in darkness. We practice the deeds of darkness. The Bible says that there is none that doeth good, none that does good, not even one person. All have sinned and come short of the glory of God. And inasmuch as God is light, we saw previously that God is light, and is in Him there is no shadow of turning, and there is no darkness at all. So anything that deviates from that standard is darkness. You cannot have half. You don't have half light. Half light is what is half light? Yeah. So light is light. Darkness is darkness. The two, they don't share common properties. They don't share similar properties. So morally, spiritually, we're in darkness until we come to Christ. And anyone who has not come to Christ, the Bible says that the God of this world has blinded their eyes so that we don't see the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. So when your eyes are blinded, then you're in the dark. When you're blindfolded, you're in the dark. Even if there's light around, something impedes the penetration of light into your eyes. Yeah? Something hampers or hinders your ability to see. And the Bible locates that person as the God of this world. Satan, the devil. So if you have a cynical view about what God, about God, about what is done through Christ, about Jesus Christ and his mission on earth, his mission, I know what he came to accomplish in your life, in my life. If you have a cynical view, if you have a hostile attitude towards that, my friend, know that you dwell in darkness. It's a natural habitat. And that's, of course, if it's a natural habitat, you will not be shocked by it because, you know, you're comfortable in it. It's like the story about a frog. You throw a live frog into in a hot water, they will jump out because it's not a natural habitat. No, they'll be shocked into, they will immediately wake up, alerted to the danger they're in. But the problem is that because we are born in darkness, without God in the world, without hope and without light, we were comfortable. It was a cozy place to be, a cozy state of affairs. And that's why we are not perturbed, we are not disturbed. In fact, the Bible produces even some starker descriptions. The Bible says that we are dead in sin. And I did mention last week or so that darkness connotes death. Light symbolizes life. So we are dead in sin, walking dead, not knowing, insensate. And I'm happy that way because we did not know the alternative. See, Bob Dylan that sang the song is his gospel releases in the late 70s called Saved. Yeah, late 70s, 80s. No. Saved. He talked about how he was born cold dead, he stepped out you know, cold dead from the womb. But God saved him by the blood of Jesus Christ, you know. So we are born cold dead, cold dead in the dark. And that was natural. So we practice sin with greediness. We practice, we just take advantage of people, you know, lie, you know, commit, you know, whatever immorality, you know, it's as if there's no tomorrow. And some of us, we are not as bad as others. Some of us, we are actually nice, you know, nice guys, gentle souls, you know, but we're still in the darkness. We're still in darkness. Yeah? It's very simple, very nice, gentle, you know, men and women, you know, but still in darkness. Okay? Darkness, as I said, is the domain of death. Darkness, there's no truth in darkness. Darkness is the domain of lies and falsehood. Darkness could not see ignorance. Darkness, depression, hopelessness. Some of these things obviously play out in some people. Some people, you know, the dimension of hopelessness. No, play that more. Some people, depression. Some people, I mean, obviously, all of us were in ignorance. Okay? So, darkness, the dominion of darkness, the power of darkness, you know, affects us in different ways. But whatever you call it, however it manifests, it's the darkness. But God is light. We saw the other day. God who commanded light to come out of darkness in Genesis 1. The Bible says it's shown into our hearts. Making known to us the glory of God as in the face of Jesus Christ. Through the gospel, as we heard the gospel, some are responding to it. Some responded to it. Some are still responding to the gospel about Jesus Christ. It's this good news. Good news to the people in darkness is that light has come. Isaiah chapter 9 verse 2. So the people that dwell in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwell in the land of the shadow of death, unto them great light has shone. Upon them great light has shone. So that's the good news. That's the gospel. That's the fantastic news to those in darkness, in pit darkness, that light has come. We can now be translated from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of light, the kingdom of God's dear Son, through the gospel, by believing in the gospel. Those who believe, they get translated. So we are called out. Not just that light shone into us, you know, we had a gospel, but also we are called out of darkness. God called you out of darkness through the gospel. God is calling some people out of darkness, even as you're listening to this, through the gospel of Jesus Christ. Of Jesus Christ. If it's not the gospel of Jesus Christ, it's not the gospel at all. It's not good news at all. It might be some moral teachings, it might be some moral exhortation, it might be some psychological, some kind of pep talk, you know, motivational speech that's meant to psych us up, but that does not give life. That does not bring light. That does not help people in darkness. If it's gospel, it's about Jesus Christ, who is the Son of God, who came into the world for the purpose of saving humanity, lost humanity. That through him we can be delivered from the destiny of death, from perdition, and unto life. You can become a child of God by receiving Jesus, the unique Son of God. Your status changes as you respond to this gospel. But it has to be the gospel of our Jesus Christ. There's no other gospel. Okay? So as you do, you are called through that gospel, you are called out of darkness. Come up! Come out! Praise God. That is scripture in Ephesians 5:14. He says, therefore, he says, awake you who sleep. Arise from the dead, and Christ will give you light. Awake, we are asleep. What else do you do in darkness? We are asleep in our sin, in our reverie, and gluttony, and drunkenness, and greed, and covetousness, and adultery, and uncleanness of different kinds. And all the great kind of warped, distorted perversion. That's more than tautology. All perversion we're in, and we're comfortable. That's why the Bible says we're dead. We're not sensitive. We're not responsive to the things of God. And then through the gospel, we are told. He says, God is saying, wake up, awake you who sleep, arise from the dead. We are dead. And Christ will give you what? Light. Christ will give you light. Praise God. Hallelujah. Like we saw in John chapter 12, Jesus declared that he came as light into the world. The Bible says that in him was light. In him was life, as life was the light of the world. So he came to the world as light. So the light shines into darkness. The light invades the darkness. But the darkness could not comprehend, could not suffocate, could not envelop it, could not comprehend it, he says. So he declared that he is the light of the world, that whoever believes in him will not abide in darkness. Whoever believes in him will not abide, will not remain in darkness. One of the scriptures we saw last week, in John chapter 8, 22. John chapter 8, verse 12, he says. So it's John 8, 22. It says there, when Jesus spoke, in fact, you know what? Let me just confirm. John 8, where are you? John 8. John 8. Say that Jesus, Lord, he who follows me shall not walk in darkness, but have the light of life. Follows me, Jesus, not anybody else, shall have the light of life, shall not walk in darkness, but have the light of life. John 8, 12, I need to correct that. Okay, praise God. So, that's the gospel we're called out of darkness. As I said before, some are responding, some are not responding. Where do you belong? Where do you belong? Okay. So the call to follow Jesus and the call to follow who is the light of the world, it implies that we come out of darkness. We cannot follow him and abide in darkness. God, that scripture tells us. You follow him, we will not walk in darkness. We walk, we have the light of life, the light that guides you on. Hallelujah. All right. Now, we now have a different identity as a result. We've seen the light, we follow the light, we come out of the light, following Jesus. Jesus, who is the light of the world, now turn us and calls us. He called us to be light of the world. In John chapter 5, verse 4. So we are the light, you are the light of the world. Oh my God. Jesus, the one that is the original light of the world, now turns around and calls me the light of the world. Because he has lightened me, you see. Like the sun has, you know, the sun has given light to the moon, and so the moon also shines. Becomes an illuminator of the earth. What a privilege. Challenge at light of the world, work accordingly. I'm preaching next week. We acquire a new identity, like light of the world. As we turn to Christ and he translates us from darkness to light, he not only changes our habitat. Now we have now belong in a different realm, a different domain. We now abide in the light. Now we in turn are made light of the world. And we are children of the day, according to 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 5. We're now supposed to walk in the light. Yes, therefore, we cannot walk in darkness if we have Christ. At least we shouldn't. I'm going to amplify that point this week. Yeah? Now that we have been lit up by Christ, illuminated by him, the true light of men, yeah, that's Christ. And now that we are children of the light, children of the light, children of the day, we are required to shine our manifestly character to the place of that John 5. No one lights a candle and puts it in a bushel, but it puts it somewhere where the light can shine. He said, therefore, let your let men see your good works, yeah, so that they can glorify your Father who is in heaven. Let your light so shine among men that they see your good works, the evidence that you are in the light, and they will glorify God, your Father who is in heaven. Why? Because those attributes they see, those light qualities that they see in you, they know that no, this don't come from this realm. It didn't come from any humanistic source. It must come from God. Because God is light. They will recognize that and give glory to him. And rightly so. Praise God. Yes. Walking in light. You are the light of the world. Hallelujah. So we are required to shine and manifest the godly character to the praise of God the Father. And I paraphrase that scripture in Matthew 5:14-16. Okay. So to summarize, I'm going to pick it up from next week. Okay. I'm going to pick it up from next week. I said that we are born in sin. Okay? We are born in sin. We are born spiritually. Body world needs to come to Christ and get born again. Our natural domain, our natural habitat is darkness, spiritual darkness, moral darkness, dark darkness. Okay? We are okay with that. We're there. No, we didn't even know what life was like, what life, felt like. So we did this of darkness. We're under the control of the prince of darkness by the God of this world, by Satan himself, to the truth about God and about the gospel. Praise God. I said that the darkness connotes death, lies, falsehood, untruth, ignorance, depression, hopelessness. I've been kicked out. Yeah? I've been thrown out. Continue next week. Wow, I was kicked out. All right.